Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I want to talk about the difference between Apple and Google for app developers. So this morning I decided once again to do the video outside, to go for a little drive and pull over to the side of the road before I head into the office, right? Today I want to talk a little bit about the differences between Apple and Google for app developers, right? I've already established early this week that I am upset with Apple because they rejected another app, right? And I've done so many apps with them, it's just something I expect, right? When I submit an app to the App Store, I think it's like a 50-50% chance of it actually going through these days, right? It's ridiculous, right? It is absolutely ridiculous the way it is, right? And I started thinking about, you know, I thought I would talk about the difference between Apple, the Apple App Store and Google Play for new app developers that are just getting into this, so you know what to be prepared for. And I think the biggest difference between Apple and Google is the mentality, which is that Google wants me to be there. Google wants app developers. The more apps Google can have, the better. They'll reject it if you break the rules. If they find you're doing something wrong, they will take it out because you're damaging the platform. But Google wants you to be there, and to Apple, the app developer is almost a nuisance, right? Now this may be unfair. I'm sure if I had Angry Birds or some big million download apps, they might be a little bit more. They might be a bit nicer to me, but this is just the way I've always found it. One of the things about Google is I'm constantly getting contacted by Google with new events, right? At one point, I remember, you know, when my first app was getting, quite a few downloads, you know, they contact me and say, hey, we would like to give you a consultant, we put a consultant on you so we can talk a little bit about how you can improve ad performance, right? And that was my first, you know, talking with an ad mob representative, right? Not everybody gets this, right? There are probably hundreds of thousands of app developers. I don't know what the actual stat is, right? But so they can't see everybody, but they are. They do want you to be there. They're always improving Google Play platform. They're giving you lots of reporting tools. Now the App Store is improving too regularly, but not the same amount, right? Like I have so much trouble with Apple that I've never got the impression that they actually want me to be there. I feel like, you know, they tolerate me. They tolerate me as an app developer. They say, oh, we have an app for that. You know, we have all these apps on the App Store. They like to talk about how many apps there are, but you know, to me, again, I might be jilted, but anybody who's ever used iTunes Connect versus the Google Play developer console knows that there's a better focus on developers on the Google Play developer console, and iTunes Connect is just a terrible user experience. Now, if you're an Apple fanboy, you might disagree with that, but that is just definitely my opinion, right? What do you guys think? I know a lot of people who watch this channel are Android-only developers, but the reason I buy this stupid iPhone, which I don't actually want, I'd rather have the Google phone or the Pixel 2 as my day-to-day device, is because I need it to test iOS 11 applications, right? My other test phones no longer work. So I'm fully in. I have to spend money on an organization that I am buying stuff from a company that doesn't like me as a developer. That's the way it feels. I mean, I might be a bit jilted. Let me know what you guys think, right? For those of you, if you just do Apple, the App Store stuff, you might think it's a great user experience. If you do Apple and Google Play, for me, I've always found Google Play to be just a much better developer experience. I mean, it's not just because they don't do reviews. I mean, if they did reviews, I think they would be better at it, right? And of course, because of they don't do reviews, Google Play is so much more crowded. Like I said, apps never die, right? They just sort of fade away. A good app never dies, it just fades away, right? Whereas on Apple, like if you don't renew your developer account, like if it's just not worth it, they go away. If they upgrade to iOS 11 and you didn't keep up with it, they go away. So Apple is very good at culling the old stuff. But, you know, I guess this is just my opinion. Let me know what you guys think. Do you, if you develop for both, do you find this? Do you find that Apple tolerates you and Google Play actually wants you to be there? Because that's the way that I've always thought of it, and that's the way it seems to me. So anyway, that's it for today. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow.